Are you ready?
Yo!
No, not yet.
Oh.
Yo! What's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Daniel.
And in this video, Daniel's going to share with us the power of Microsoft Lists and how we can use that advantage with Power BI. Stay tuned. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both
Daniel,
Patrick, and this guy. All right, Daniel, thank you so much for being with us.
Yes, on this video. Thank you for having me.
If people haven't noticed, I just kicked Patrick out of his cube and I've taken over.
It's kind of a small cube you got.
It's all right. So Daniel is with us to share us the beauty of Microsoft Lists. So I'm struggling with a little bit because I think SharePoint Lists.
Yes, you probably do. And that's probably because they're the same thing.
Okay.
Well, Microsoft Lists are SharePoint Lists, but they could also be stored in OneDrive too.
Interesting.
So, but if you know SharePoint Lists, you know Microsoft Lists.
All right. So enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to your machine.
All right. We have a list here for event plans. And something that we've had for a little while now is this integration with Power BI to be able to visualize this list.
But before we visualize the list, I just want to comment on all the colors here.
Isn't that
beautiful?
A friend of mine does a great job of list formatting. His name is Chris Kent. He's amazing. Another MVP.
Awesome.
I learned a lot from him. So we can visualize this list. And in the context of this list, we are generating a report, and this is Power BI getting insights. So this is an amazing report page. I didn't have to do anything.
I will say that this report page is better than something I would create.
It's better than I would create. We're using the service to do the work for us. There is a little bit of a gotcha here. Before I get to that, I can publish to the list. When I publish this, I'm going to do events. Yo, and then I'm going to show you what that did when I do that publish. We're going to be able to go in and get access to this. I can actually edit what we're doing with each one of these visualizations.
I love personalization.
Yeah, so we can personalize these, make it what we want to. We're done. Great.
Yep.
We go back to our list, and now we go back to integrate and go back to Power BI. There's events.
Ooh.
Of course, everyone who accesses this is going to need a Power BI license to be able to get to this.
Okay, so the Microsoft 365 licensing doesn't automatically cover
it. It does not.
Okay. What if they have an E5 license that includes Power BI Pro?
Then they can access it.
Okay.
Absolutely. The problem with this is this report lives within the context of the list. I can't go to the service and get access to that report.
So if I go to the service, I'm not going to see this report anywhere.
No. In the context of the list, that's great. I can come back, visualize, get insights. But what if I want to share this maybe in Teams or on my SharePoint page and embed it like a report? Well, now we can go to export to Power BI. This is going to allow us to pull in that list as a data set. Yeah. So I can be accessing the data in the list and editing it, adding new records.
It's setting up that connection for us and all of the hard things that we got to do to set this up.
Yeah.
And it's doing that for us.
We then can create those wonderful reports that then we can create dashboards off of. We can embed those reports on SharePoint sites.
And it's just normal Power BI.
Normal.
All right.
Absolutely.
And it sets up like the refresh automatically for that?
Absolutely not.
Okay. No. Okay, it doesn't. So we have to set up schedule refresh.
Just like any other data set. Remember, we went and said that was a cool looking report.
It was.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Do that and then come here, create a report that mimics that.
Yeah.
And start from there and do some amazing things.
And or if you just want people to do it in the Microsoft list itself, you're good to go.
That's right.
What do you think about this? Are you using SharePoint lists? Is this something you've explored? Have you hit challenges with it? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If this is your first time here to Guy in a Cube, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Adam,
Daniel,
and Patrick, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.